Hi there. Because of some technical limitations, I had to choose between having a face cam and some decent audio. And you might wanna guess which one I choose? In case you couldn't tell, this is not my real face. So here's the thing, we are going to stick to this method right now. And yes, so I should explain what you are seeing right now. So not so long ago, I made this post on Instagram that I will take some free requests, and I offered 3 slots and they were taken in like 20 minutes, which was fun. And then I ended up creating 3 artworks, and in this video you will see the very first one. So the first picture is a D&D character in a scene. I should mention now that originally I just wanted to make 3 single character portraits, maybe little and easy backgrounds, but you know how it goes, I went a little too far with it. The requester and I talked about this character and came up with the idea that I'll make a scene from one of their game sessions where this party infiltrated a ball in a castle held by vampires. And it's not even October yet, it still feels like a Halloween illustration, right? So the requester's friend wanted to claim one more slot and make it a picture of their characters within the same scene together, but the 2 other were already claimed, so we settled down with adding the other character into the background, and it was a great decision, and I will explain why I'm saying that later. So this character's name is Zeros, who's a rogue who dressed up as a celebrity for this event, with the rest of the party impersonating her bodyguards, and the person in the back is Kevin, who's an elf, one of her bodyguards. I didn't plan out what the whole story would be, I just started to add elements to this picture as a sketch and they just started to grow, and I ended up with this composition where Zeros is just making her way through the room and trying not to look suspicious as she's pouring that glass of blood out the window while Kevin is watching her back. The picture was highly inspired by one specific Picasso painting and the Beauty and the Beast movies, especially the 2017 movie, and just by many pieces of Gothic imagery, you know, all those. So actually, this ended up being pretty much the most complex picture I've ever made. And you know, it's just a simple one-point perspective, and I used many effect layers to achieve this look, so at the end, you know, it was really beneficial to add those light rays and everything. Almost none of it was planned, it was just a simple sequence of actions that led me to this stage. And you know, I'm happy with it. But here's the catch. So we arrived to the present, 2 months after the picture was finished, and in the meantime I tried out some things and figured out how I could make one of these videos, and also I practiced my English because it was painful to listen to before that. So here is how far I went, and you know, I looked at this picture and I wanted to pretty much fix everything, but in the end I decided that I want to fix the main points of the picture and stuff that is really off. So I wanted to improve the rendering on her face and on her hand, this hand, because it just looks awful as it is. The another focal point of the picture is Kevin here in the background, who turned out, well, he turned out okay, but you know, not the kind of main character vibe that I was hoping to get. And the other thing are these bats. You know, they are pretty poorly rendered and I wanted to improve them a little bit because they are this main hint on the picture that it's actually, you know, this gothic vampire ball, and other than, you know, Nosferatu being here, these are the stuff that hint that actually what you see here is a glass of blood, and you know, this thing, the blood moon, the bats, and you just start to combine this story together and you will find out what this place really is. So I jumped into a few hours of rendering after this. So the first thing I wanted to fix is the face of Zeros, which has a much prettier render now. Because this original, it was just, you know, full of mess. And there's this giant artifact here, this, you know, when I resized her eye, you know, these rings stayed here, and for some reason I didn't see that back then. Because, you know, it's just, like, so obvious, it's painful, but I ended up removing those and pretty much reworking everything a little bit, making it like a little more realistic with this part of the face being much more in the dark. I mean, it's still pretty weird that the moon is lighting it from almost from the back, so this thing would be a rim light. You know, this is one of those artistic choices that might not be the best, but I wanted to go with this and show properly the whole character. I ended up reworking both of her hands. This one actually turned out pretty great. And I also made some rendering on the clothing, and I think it's better now. It has like this really strong effects that show the form. Okay, next we go to Kevin, who's actually much better in this version, in my opinion. So it was just blank, like this character that blends into the background. So if I remove this blue color, then you won't even see that this is someone who's important. So there's not much to say, I just added more details and I refined the rendering. That's all, but the whole character now looks a bit more distinctive, especially with these yellow details on the clothing. Before that, it was just a giant blob. Like a participant who, unlike others, just had a blue coat, and that's it. So the another thing that I reworked are these bats, and then I decided to make the moon a little bit more detailed. And now you just see now how bad they originally were, like these were just blobs, like if it was like a cardboard cutout that somebody threw off the roof. But now I actually rendered these wings. And you know, these are one of those creatures that are really recognizable and look really interesting when rendered properly. And that is pretty much all I changed. You know, I could go on and pretty much touch up every single character. And I'm not saying that I won't do that in the future. Maybe if I want to improve this piece for my portfolio, I might work on it a little bit. So this is the real final version of this painting. So many elements of this piece is just eye candy, like these giant chandeliers with the many candles. And you know, I wanted to make every character a little unique. So how I imagine someone would see this picture for the first time is that they are immediately drawn to this red dress, because in this environment this red is the most distinctive color, and that's the first thing that you notice. Then you see the glass that is being pulled out the window, underneath a blood moon with some bats and some, you know, gothic tower in the distance, and then you just piece together the details that it is a ball held by vampires, and then you see that there's the waiter with the plate of glasses. And you know, it's like a little story that Zeros was coming in this direction, grabbed one of these glasses to not look suspicious, and now she's pulling it out the window, because of course she doesn't want to drink that. If you don't count Orlok, then these are the main hints about the story. And you know, there's Kevin, who's the second focal point, the other really saturated colored person in the picture who's watching from the distance, and you immediately recognize that these two are together in this mission. So the thing is that the whole picture is desaturated, and these two characters, the two main characters, are the ones who really stand out. These are the two who have really detailed clothing, these are the two that have like healthy looking skin, like everyone else is really pale. Count Orlok, who's an Easter egg, is just, he just playing himself, let's just say that. These two characters are really far from each other, and not just in a physical space, but they are also, you know, separated by this whole crowd of desaturated people. One major thing I wanted to mention is that I had a pretty weird approach to this piece, and I kept everything on separate layers. So if you check this out, like, this is how many layers I have, which is like ridiculous. I regularly have like 4 or something like that. But you know, maybe a little different approach would have been better. Maybe, you know, using a 3D base or something. But as the time being, with this simple one-point perspective and with many characters, I'm pretty satisfied with this picture. You know, this is one of those that has mistakes, that has flaws, that is not perfect, far from perfect. But I like it for what it is, and I'm pretty proud of it. So the thing that I like the best in the piece is just the whole atmosphere, storytelling with colors. And also, I mentioned that Xeros was dressed up as a celebrity on this event. And originally, this dress featured like a pentagram and an upside down cross. But I talked with the requester and we decided that it would be just too much, like, you know, this is some out of place imagery. So then I decided to kind of hide it. But if you look at this shape, this is a pitchfork, like this is the handle and the three, what are they called, the pointy stuff, head of the pitchfork, I'm not sure what it is called. Okay, I'm a little bit afraid that I might talk for a little too long for this video. So in the end, I wanted to say that this was a really nice experience to have, and I really like how this picture turned out. And of course, I will just look at it in a few months or few years and I will say that, you know, okay, this is just horrendous, I didn't know what I was doing, but at this time I'm satisfied with it, and you know, it was a really great experience. So about the two other pictures and the two other videos, I'm planning to release them within like a week or two. Okay, about the future, there's this person on Instagram called Map Graves. And it hasn't been posted, but she hosts a challenge every year for Halloween for the October month called the Mabs Drellowin Club. And I participated in the challenge last year. This year I want to complete the whole list and record everything. I'm not sure how it will turn out. I'm still trying to figure out how this whole thing is supposed to be done, but if you stick around, then we will see together. Okay, so here we go. Thank you very much for watching if you watched through the whole video, and I hope that we will see each other soon. I'm coming with the next request soon, so farewell for now, and see you in the next video.